Our direct physical harms. Disaster also separate children from their family. In disaster situation, any critical infrastructure like a structure from primary health sector, a school, homes, damage directly impact on children. So survival of the children. So this is vital to which are vital to children for survival. So to need to take a special care to children during disaster situation. In generally, disaster situation, in emergency situation, any complex emergency situation, children become highly vulnerable because nobody hear voice of the children during disaster. I have experience when I went in Nepal earthquake in 2015, I visited in Kathmandu, number of children affected due to earthquake. And nobody can meet to those children in disaster situation. So the children voice are not here during disaster situation. Children always neglected in emergency situation. This is the situation. But the disaster create different type of impact on the children. First of all, I discuss about how disaster may affect the routine life of the children. First of all, in normal position, children wake up early in the morning, take refreshment, food, go to school and return back to home. This type of routine life follow up. But in any emergency situation, in any emergency situation like earthquake, tsunami, in case of example, like COVID-19 situations, school closed down for longer time of period. So due to this emergency situation, routine life of the children also disrupted due to different impact of disasters. So children are more vulnerable. Second impact, discuss about the physical impact. How to disaster harm to the children. The children health may be more vulnerable in a disaster for a biophysical reason. Generally, in case of earthquake or any flood affected area, children or physical chances of disaster impact on children is more vulnerable because disaster children may be physically harmed, yeah, maybe separated from their parents, maybe injured, maybe killed. And during the disaster situation, in case of flood, generally in case of flood, I was a district project officer during the Kosi flood 2008. The proper supply of essential vitamin and nutrition also disrupted during the flood situation. Most of the children live in the shelters. Proper intake of nutritious food also lacking of proper intake of nutritious food also directly impact the health of the children. So generally in disaster situations, children are highly vulnerable. Children become highly vulnerable in these situations. Affect the medical facilities for the children, disaster illness, injury caused by disaster. This situation, we have unable to give a special care, give a medical treatment to children is very not properly given to children. So non-disaster related problem also untreated during the emergency situation. Children also suffer from malnutrition due to proper food supply or proper nutritious food and vitamin intake. Children health is also affected due to emergency situation. So keep the time of growing period is 0 to 18 years, children need special care, more care. And during the situation, any disaster happens, children become more vulnerable and it directly impact to his, directly to the routine life, directly impact to their mental health issues also. So this type of situation created during the disaster situation. In case of COVID-19, how COVID impacted on disasters? We all know, this COVID-19 situation is unprecedented situation. Directly, this situation is unprecedented. Our children are more vulnerable in different categories, in different types. This is directly impacted to the exacerbating the learning crisis. Children are suffering from children are facing a learning crisis. Children also survival issues also very important, increases during this COVID-19 situation. Child protection is also increasing. Child protection, child trafficking, and child abuse also increasing during this situation. So need to take a special care in emergencies is very important for disaster situations. Any disaster like earthquake, flood, cyclones. Now discuss about how the childhood affected during the disasters. Generally, suppose one of the study report, UNICEF report for Andhra and Karnataka 26 and 36 in 2005 to 2015, a study report of UNICEF in which drought affected area Karnataka and Andhra. 36% children suffering from stunting and 26% children become affected due to wasting. Some background noise is coming, sir. So, stunting, first of all, we have to define stunting. Failure to grow adequately in height in indication of malnutrition. In general, lack of proper nutritious food, food supplies, lack of proper adequate food supply, the height of the children not increasing according to their age. Similarly, this is considered stunting. And being underweight, major weight for age, then the weight of the children not increases according to their age, then it is major testing. Testing measured by weight for height scores. So this type of situation created due to the lack of proper consumption of food supply among the affected area. So generally any type of disaster situation in COVID-19, for example, we take the COVID-19 situation, number of children, rural children, lack of midday meal. Due to lack of proper supply of food in the affected area. Proper supply of food is not accessible for children. So this situation directly impacts the overall growth of the children according to their age, according to their weight, according to their height. This is the difference normal, wasted and standard wasted. This is not more. Another issue is created during disaster situation, water and sanitation practices. This is a very important issue for disaster situation, lack of proper and safe drinking water, lack of proper sanitation services become more hygienic for the children. And hygienic conditions created generally in flood situation, in flood, during and after flood, cases of diarrhea, cholera, and other diseases will be increased. Generally, I had experience from Madhepura. I was the district project officer in that area. Most of the water resources located in low-lying area. People are really supposed to take water from low-lying hygienic conditions. So this type of situation always seen in flood affected area create more panic to the people, create more lack of safety, while chances of number of cases of diarrhea, cholera, intestinal also increase in this flood affected area. And diarrheal illness lead to dehydration and malnutrition among the children. And dehydration can also become life-threatening for the babies and children also. So the water and sanitation is also a major issue during the disaster situation. In COVID-19 situation, according to UNICEF report, 40% of the children are not able to, all over the world, not able to use proper water and soap during the COVID-19 situation. So this type of water and sanitation in the current scenario of COVID-19 is also very important, because do's and don'ts, according to the guideline of the ministry, do's and don'ts all are followed up. So hand washing practices and proper soap, water and soap sanitation, hygiene practices are also very important. So water and sanitation issues also found in affected area and disaster situation. Another issue now, how disaster affect schooling of the children. In generally disaster situation, in case of, for example, in case of the earthquake, or tsunami, or flood, mass displacement, school is used as a shelter. Loss of school infrastructure due to disaster always seen during the earthquake situation. Loss of school learning material in disaster situation also find. Loss of school time and closure also not clear during the disaster situation. Lack of access to school. Children also facing the lacking of access to schools. The dropout cases also increased during the disaster situation. So this type of impact is seen during disaster situation. And children become more affected during the disaster situation. Road injury, accident during school times, also chances of road injury, accident also find during disaster situation. This type of issues created.
Partho dake phone kore to. পার্থদা ফোন করেছিল, কেটে গেল, আমি ক্লাসে আছি তো।
রিগার্ডিং এফেক্ট অন মেন্টাল হেলথ ইস্যুস। মেন্টাল হেলথ ইস্যুস অলসো ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট ফর দ্য চিলড্রেনস ইন এনি ডিজাস্টার ইমার্জেন্সি সিচুয়েশনস। এন্ড আ স্পেশাল ক্লাস হ্যাজ টেকেন বাই দ্য এক্সপার্টস অন মেন্টাল হেলথ ইস্যুস। বাট এনি ডিজাস্টার উই হ্যাভ সিন ইন দ্য পিকচারস দ্যাট দিস ইজ দ্য টাইম অফ সুনামিস। The family of this children lost parents, loss of parents directly impact to the mental health issues of the children, mothers and all. So the event itself are stressful and frightening. Natural disaster can cause mildly harmful for the children. Children live in a stress in disaster. If their parents are living in a stress, then children also directly impact to the children. The mental health issues also. If any children lost their parents and become orphan, long-term impact on their life cycle also. So this type of situation normally found in disaster situations. So take a special care and take a special need a special provide a special services like mental counseling, all the type of services is very important during the disaster situation. When loved one or missing origin, children may have a harder time to cope with such losses. Children upset and their caregiver, agar children ke dekhbhal karne wale caregiver lost and live in a stress, children also feeling stress during the disaster situation. So when parents have high level of poor disaster symptoms, children have high level as well. This type of condition find during the disaster situation. So need to take a special care to the children for their mental health issues. Children in time of COVID-19, number of children are living in a state because they are not going to school, they are not taking proper food, they are nutritious food, they are midday meal. Children, number of children living, falling in poverty. So this type of children are also interacting with the learning crisis. Interpreting of the learning crisis also directly impacts the children's mental health issues. Children's survival and health is also affected. Child protection is another issue also directly back to the children. So this type of situation created normally in disaster situations. Another issues created generally found in disaster situation. Children are being forced to work as a bonded labor, or child labor. Children become orphans. Cases of child marriage is also increased during disaster situation. Child trafficking. The number of example of such type of children facing challenges like bonded labor. And for example, COVID-19, number of cases of child marriages, child trafficking is also increasing. This is the case study of during the time of tsunami. How tsunami impact on the long-term impact on the children and their parents. This is the name is Sarna, dropout from during the tsunami. During the loss, her parents were forced to do household chores also. He could not marry with her choice. She could not marry with her choice. Lack of robust support during the delivery of child. This type of situation, child is differently able because of heredity. So this type of situation. She is still in a living in trauma, psychological trauma. So the number of cases have seen during the tsunami periods. This now let's see about how disaster affect life cycle approach of the children. So before discussing about the impact of disaster, risk and vulnerability on different stages of life cycle of the children, first of all, as a disaster manager or as a disaster planner, first of all, disasters can be best addressed. If you have formulated any development program for children, first of all, you have to go for situation analysis. What is the risk of the children, what is the vulnerability of the children of different age groups, according to their age, according to their gender-related needs, and then formulate any development program for the children. Because children are full dependent on their parents. So the parental age starting during the pregnancy period. Need to a special care. So starting from the parental state, need of a special care, a scale of dependency of children for survival worries. The risk here, dependency of children vary according to their age. So then the special need and care is very important for the children, for different age group of the children. So service rendered by the duty bearer or invariably at the risk of being eroding is leading the disaster. During the disaster or any complex emergency situation, the rendered services also disrupted. The services also disrupted for the children. Proper meal, proper intake of vitamins, proper immunization process, all hampered during the disaster situation. So need a special care of different age groups of the children. Another social norms and practices also be considered during the formulation of disaster DRR program or any DRR activity related to the children. So social norms practices such as gender discrimination, child marriage, child labor, etc. get accentuated during disaster and affect different life phases of disaster. क्योंकि सोशल नॉर्म्स एंड प्रैक्टिसेस जेंडर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन, चाइल्ड मैरिज, चाइल्ड लेबर पे नंबर ऑफ केसेस इंक्रीजेस ड्यूरिंग दिस डिजास्टर सिचुएशन व्हेन डिजास्टर हैपेंड इन डायरेक्टली इंपैक्ट ऑन लाइफ डिफरेंट लाइफ फेजेस ऑफ द चिल्ड्रन. वी हैव सीन इन द पिक्चर दैट डिफरेंट लाइफ फेजेस ऑफ द लाइफ साइकिल डिफरेंट फेजेस ऑफ द चिल्ड्रन. फर्स्ट फिटस इन द यूम, सेकेंड इज द बेबी इन्फेंट फ्रॉम वन टिल वन ईयर नीड अ स्पेशल केयर. वन टू थ्री ईयर चाइल्ड हुड फेज, वन टू ट्वेल्व ईयर फेज चाइल्ड हुड फेज, एंड 13 to 19 ईयर फेज इज द एडोलेसेंस फेज. तो लाइफ ऑफ चाइल्ड कैन बी डिवाइड इन टू वेरियस फेजेस, डिफरेंट फेजेस वी ऑल सीन इन द पिक्चर्स. Life of the cycle can be divided into various depending on the age and the scale of the. According to age and the scale of the children, that is the vulnerability of the vulnerability is also very different, have different. So important to consider the age specific, gender specific need, vulnerability capacity, while CCD or activity are dinner. If it is very important to consider age specific, gender specific needs of the different age groups of children in. Children is also considered, also need to consider. So when you are design, when you design any CCD or activity formulation or program design. Now discuss. Life cycle need to be done to be ensure provision of efficient timely services to care the needs of the different group of children in all phases of it. All phases. We all know, that children are fully dependent on their parents, their caregivers, and different age group of children, according to the different age group of the children, different type of this, need different type of services, care, special care is also very important. So need to be ensure the provision to time, at a efficient time, the service is very important. To cater the need of different age group of the children is also very essential, especially in the disaster situation. Child required changes in each phase. Typically, normally the different requirement of child requirement change according to their age, according to their different phase of life cycle. So time to critical services and care is very essential for the different age group of the children, as well as effective practices such as rendered to order to address their needs and rights. It is very important. Now discuss about how disaster impact on different phases of the different life cycle phases of the children. First phase, prenatal phase. Prenatal phase from the first 1,000 days or 9 months of pregnancy and first 2 years the phase of prenatal phase need to a special care, more special care. And this phase, this time the life is most delicate, and that this time services need to a special care and timely services is very important. Child rights also start from parental stage itself. So need to a special, children are highly vulnerable, children become highly most delicate as well as highly vulnerable. This is very highly vulnerable phase also. So need to a special care. Children and their mother both are highly susceptible to direct and indirect effect of disaster. If disaster happens, directly impact to the children's survival. Also, emergency climate change condition, exposure, disaster can exhibit vulnerability. So, what is the vulnerability? The children exhibit the vulnerability of the children due to the climate change condition, due to the disaster, different frequency of disaster. So, need to a special care for the children. For the prenatal phase of the children. Need well-timed access to obstetrics and care for child birth, antenatal care and postnatal services are the need and right of this life phase. It is very essential for give special medical care, pre-antenatal care, child wards, postnatal services are also very important for the children. Now this effective measures. Effective measures may first the point is the listing of expecting mother. First of all, have to prepare the list of expecting mothers for proper monitoring and provide a special support for institutional delivery during the disaster situation. Also ensure MISP kits, material for natural hygiene, so appropriate shelters and other bath services during the disaster risk of child. It is very important for survival of the children. So a special services like kids, hygiene socks and other shelters and bath services is also very important. Ensure various social protection scheme also is very important, like public distribution systems and very relevant action for early recovery of disaster impact families. So these are the effective measures also have to taken during in affected area for early recovery of the children families, and also in course, it is also very important for the survival of the children. Second phase, 0 to 2 year phase is the second year phase. Young children need two to three hour breastfeeding. Among this, 0 to 2 year children need more care up to 6 months. This 0 to 2 year phase, they also need a special care because breastfeeding is very essential also essential for child growth and survival. They receive exclusive breastfeeding, and beyond 6 months they can be supported for appropriate complementary feeding is also very essential during the disaster for the children, for second phase of the children. During and after disaster, chances of lactation failure also very high due to the psychological shocks. Due to the effect of mental or psychological shocks or disasters on their parents. So major issue as there can be several child is very important. In second phase, in any disaster happens, chances of loss of proper care is also very, lack of proper care is also another issue found during the disaster. Survival and growth of the children also directly impact during the disaster for the 0 to 2 year children. If mass displacement happen in a disaster affected area, also disrupt the immunization schedule for the 0 to 2 year children, also create health issue for the children, increase the chances of effect of the disease is also found. Next, what effective practices need during for the 0 to 2 year children? So, a strong preparedness to provide vaccination in mass displacement situation is critical to safeguard from any epidemics. It is for survival of the children, vaccination is very important. 0 to 2 year children, vaccination or immunization is most important for the safeguard from any type of epidemics. So need to prepare and provide vaccination during mass displacement situation in disaster affected areas. And also support 0 to 2 year children taking effort for working with parents as stakeholders and can benefit disaster. Also need to take a moral support, provide support to their parents, parents of 0 to 2 year children for yearly recovery. Also provide safe drinking water and sanitation services is also very important to be taken care during disaster situation or complex emergency situation for 0 to 2 year children. now discuss about third phase. Third phase consider in a 3 to 5 year phase. 3 to 5 year phase of the child life cycle is also very important part importance. Because majority of brain development happens during this phase. Need to a special care and also need a special clinical services like immunization, proper nutritious food and other services are also very important for the 0 to 5 years children. If disaster happens, damage and loss of organ body and disruption of nutrition and early childhood education services also directly impact to the 3 to 5 year children's development, growth and development. So generally in disaster situation, generally in disasters like earthquake, air flood, also take example of COVID-19, number million of children suffer from proper services, loss of organ body and other immunization services, lack of nutritious food, childhood education services also disrupted during this COVID-19 situation due to lockdown, due to unprecedented situation of COVID-19. So generally any emergency conditions also need to a special care of the children. So 3 to 5 year children are more vulnerable. Because this stage is also very important. Major development, major growth of the children happens during this period. I need a special care, need a special service. Childhood education is also very important. Nutritious food also very important for 3 to 5 of children, for the growth of the children. So this is very important. What effective practices need to take care? So first, establish of a temporary Aganwadi services along with vast facility and immunization in situation of displacement. If mass displacement happens in disaster situation, suppose that in case of tsunami and case of cyclone, need to take a special care to the children and provide established temporary Aganwadi services with proper vast facility and immunization services very essential for the growing children. Recreation or sports, game, playing are central for growth of the children in this phase. Ensure facility of recreation, facility of other services like provides sports and games like activity related. Recreational sports and game play are also very important. Establishment of child friendly spaces is also more important for with access to age appropriate recreational and learning materials is also important to take care in for preparedness process. Maintaining kits of stationery, toy, games, etc. can be important in disaster preparedness activity for the development of the children is also important for growing children, for 3 to 5 year children. Now discuss about the 6 to 12 year middle childhood phase जो होता है उसके बारे में डिस्कस करते हैं. क्रिटिकल सर्विसेज एंड केयर इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इस 6 to 12 ईयर फेज मिडिल चाइल्डहुड फेज चिल्ड्रेन स्टार्ट फॉर्मल स्कूलिंग रिक्रिएशनल ऑल्सो टेक पार्ट इन रिक्रिएशनल एक्टिविटी टेक पार्ट इन स्पोर्ट्स ड्यू टू डिजास्टर्स ऑल दिस टाइप ऑफ एक्टिविटी डिस्टर्बेड एफेक्टेड this type of situation directly impact the growth of and development of the children because children are not able to take part in sports, not take part in educational activity, their formal schooling also become disturbed. So this situation created and so once disaster all gets significantly disrupted. So the post disaster most of the school use as a shelter. Center. So school days will be lost, children are also feeling school days will be lost, chances of school days will be lost. In most cases, school will be used as a shelter for mass dispersion for patients. So this type of situation directly impact to the children, the recreational activity, sport, physical growth and for the 6 to 12 year children. Need to take a special measures and effective practices for 6 to 12 year children. Like this along with CA, child-friendly services, learning space with curriculum are important. In curriculum or learning spaces is also very important for the 6 to 12 year children. Ensure yearly reopening Effective practices like provide child friendly spaces, provide learning spaces with curriculum, they are also very important for the growing children. Yearly reopening of the school is to ensure yearly reopening of the school is also very important. To ensure protection of children is also very important during the disaster situation. Help their parents to focus on yearly recovery and reconstruction needs. In the sense of looking after the safety and security of the children. For safety and security of the children, need to more focus on yearly recovery of their parents and others' reconstruction needs. Now discuss about 12 to 18 years adolescence phase. This phase is also need a special care, time critical services and care is also very important during the 12 to 18 year adolescent children. Adolescents have the capacity to get into their role of active agent of the change. So, adolescents actively part in different activities. Sexual and reproductive health issues also menstruation high in the rape affected during the disaster situation. This is the child protection. Is another issue also highly affected during the disaster. Any disaster issues like COVID-19, child protection issues and child protection is also accentuated during this COVID situation. Most of the children are highly vulnerable and their parents and the children are affected with COVID-19 or COVID positive. Children protection issues are also accentuated. So child protection gets compromised after disasters. Highly vulnerable to problems like child marriage, child labor, gender-based violence, traffic injury after disaster. So 12 to 18 year chances of child marriages or child labor or gender-based violence, trafficking also become more high. And khas karke 12 to 18 year adolescent children more vulnerable, highly vulnerable from child labor, yeah, any type of gender violence, yeah, any kind child of trafficking cases. What effective practices need for the children of 12 to 18 years? So, partners of adolescent engagement in DRR activities are also very important. Actively participation is very important for engagement of children is also very important. So need to take to provide ensure a mechanism provide a platform to participate the children in DRR activity. More engagement is also very important for adolescent children. Continuity of learning opportunities and ensure continuity of learning opportunities also very important for the children. Hygiene improvement practices, sports and recreation activity facilities also need to take care for development of the children to 6 to 12 year children. So this type of effective measure is also very important for the different age group of the children. Way forward. Youth volunteer can enable local action. Need to train youth volunteers. Youth volunteers can also enable local action for disaster. This is also take a special care. Development of social entrepreneurship for skills building of youth to create employment opportunity. This type of disaster preparedness measure is also very important. Now let's say. Discuss about some child rights and commitment of the commitments regarding to commitment, international commitments. It is also very important for children. and by ground of the United Nations, rights of the child, the UN General Secretary adopted this convention on 20th November 1999. It came into force in 2nd September 1999. This convention of rights of the child applies for all type of children in all countries, all type of children. So a state has responsibility to ensure the human rights respected, protected and fulfilled all rights. So during the generally disaster situation, a state unable to provide a full support to due to humanitarian crisis, a state unable to fulfill role. So that situation need to a special support from external support is also very important. So a state's responsibility to ensure the human rights. This convention has 54 articles that cover all aspects of child lives related to civil rights, related to political rights, related to environmental, social and cultural rights also. So it also explains how adults and government must work together to make all children can enjoy all their rights. UNCRC is also very important for the protection of the children. And it provides all rights to the children regarding to protection, regarding to development, regarding to education. So it has four principles. This convention works on four principles. Best interest of the child, first best interest of the child, second, this convention also focus on non-discrimination. This is another principle involved for the development of the children. It's also listening the view of the children. So this fourth principle, this child rights convention has four principles, best interest of the child, non-discrimination, development, view of the child. Four major rights also highlighted in this convention: child for survival, child for development, child for participation, child for protection. These four rights is also very essential for survival and protection and growth of the children during the disaster situation. In complex emergency yeah, any type of disaster situation, this right also not fulfilled by the state. Children are not able to to advocate for their right, not taken care to these rights. Major rights is survival, development and protection. Some articles, most important article mentioned in this convention is who is the child. Person below the age of 18 considered as the child according to these conventions. This convention also highlighted the definition of non-discrimination. Convention apply for all children, whatever their race, what is the religion, what is the, you know, no matter. So convention apply for all children. No discrimination according to their race and religion or their ability. Article 22 also described about the right to say. Children have the right to say what they think, what should happen when adults are making decisions. Any decision making process need to participate. Children is very also important. And this Article 12 give a right to the children to right to say. Another article 6 also very important, survival and development for the children. It provides right to the children regarding to children have the right to live, right to survive and develop healthy. This article provides survival and development related rights to the children. Article 9 also discuss about their parents. Children should not be separated from their parents unless it is not their own good. So, this is also very important. The responsibility of the state is to ensure this right to the children during the complex emergency situations. The right to education, Article 28 also highlighted about the right to education. Children have right to an education, primary education should be also free. This is also important, say, right for the children according to the conventions. The right to quality health care is also very essential. Article 24 mentions about the children have right to good quality of health care, nutritious food, clean environment. Right to quality health care is also important for the children. So Article 24 give all the rights regarding to health, nutritious food and clean environment for the healthy stage for the children. Right to convention also describe about Article 31 also describe about the all children have a right to relax and play freely. So Article 31 give right to the children to play freely and relax. Freedom of association also mentioned in this kind of right to meet together and join group and organization is also mentioned in this convention of the rights. Right to privacy is also mentioned. Right to protection from against the way of life is also very mentioned in this. Children with disabilities should also mention in this convention. Children who have any kind of disability have the right to a special care and support as well as right in the convention. So this convention also described about the children and the children with disabilities and their rights. This convention also working on the principle of best interest of the child, that the best interest of the children must be primary concern in decision-making processes also mentioned in this convention. Make all measures to ensure children's rights are respected and protected and fulfilled. These are the rights given in the convention. Goal of education is also mentioned in this convention. So child protection and child rights is also very important for the during the disaster situation to be taken care effectively. During the disaster situation, child trafficking, child labor, sexual exploitation, early marriage cases associated. So need to a special care as a duty bearer, as a caregiver, as a parent, our responsibility to take care of the children during the disaster situation or provide all these rights mentioned in the convention is also essential. Way forward may need to protect children. Also, it is very important to protect children in emergency for working for safeguard of the rights of the children, both children in their activity, power to children to take more participation, empower children for preparing for any type of disaster situation, for challenges. Thank you.